Hi friends, my name is Chaitanya Patke and welcome back to my YouTube channel. Now I am going to make this video about a very specific topic and a topic of particular interest of the Indian cricket fans, and many of them have this valid question, but I think your intention and the question's direction is a little bit misinterpreted, or you have gone a little bit haywire. I am talking about you fans. As we know that I made a video some time ago that why Ishan Kishan and Shreyas Iyer were not included in the BCCI central contract list for 2024, and why actually it was a great decision by the BCCI, which actually sent a message to many budding players that who are running after an IPL contract, that you earns crores or lakhs of rupees by entering an IPL team, perform there, and if you are lucky, you are going to enter the Indian team. That message was going to the youngsters, and BCCI did very well to not only reinforce its own power but also reinforce the power and the importance of Ranji Trophy, Syed Mushtaq Ali Trophy, as well as the Vijay Hazare Trophy. So all in all, great work by the BCCI. But many people in the other breath are also thinking that why the hell only Ishan Kishan and Shreyas Iyer were terminated from their central contracts. Why not mete out the same treatment to Hardik Pandya? Now, people with their wild imagination have many theories, that some of the theories were actually pretty ridiculous. I was reading on the internet while researching on this topic that the current BCCI secretary, Mr. Jay Shah, is from the state of Gujarat. So he is not willing to mete out the same treatment to Hardik Pandya because he also belongs to the same state. Hardik Pandya is also the captain of Gujarat Titans, and as we know that Mr. Jay Shah has relationship between relationship of Gujarat Cricket Association, where he worked for I think 7 or 8 years in the past. So all kind of theories are doing down the ground, and I am just there to provide a clarification that why Hardik Pandya was not only retained in the A contract, why he is in the, and what is his role in the larger scheme of things. So first of all, we have to take into consideration that Hardik Pandya currently does not play any red ball cricket at all. By the way, his last test was when he played for Team India was in 2018 in Southampton. After that, he hasn't been able to play a single test match due to various reasons. Now, if you remember, just on the eve, just before the World Test Championship final, which took place at the Oval last year in 2023 between India and Australia, actually, some reporter asked Hardik Pandya, who was then fit. I am talking about just after the conclusion of the IPL and just before the WTC final, that if the need arises, will you be able to take part for Team India in the solitary test if Team India requires your services? Hardik Pandya immediately replies that no, I didn't take part in the single game of the WTC cycle, and it will be unfair on the guys who actually played and who had a major role in India getting to the final, so I won't be able to play test cricket as of now. He has also mentioned to a query by some reporter few years ago that Hardik, when are you going to return to red ball cricket? What are your plans regarding your future in the test cricket? He bluntly said that let me be able to first be fit for the white ball matches, the ODIs as well as the T20s, then we will talk about the IPL. Now due to his history of various injuries, and those injuries have been pretty severe one, right from his back injury in the 2018 Asia Cup, which took place in Dubai, and his shoulder injuries, his knee injuries, he has suffered all kind of injuries, so he is actually a little bit more injury prone than some other cricketers if you compare. But we have to take into consideration that the bodies of some player are prone to breaking down more often than other. I would categorize Jasprit Bumrah in that category, but Jasprit Bumrah's fitness is touch wood holding up pretty well, and that should be the case. Coming back to the Hardik Pandya's case, the amount of time or the natural talent that he has in unquestionable, no doubt about it, but whenever he is fit, he puts in more than 100%, and that's why his body sometimes breaks down. There is no particular reason for it, so it doesn't make sense for the BCCI to force Hardik Pandya to play in the test format or in the Ranji Trophy in the first class cricket, because his body isn't been able to cope to the demands of the white ball format. So it makes absolutely no sense that Hardik Pandya should 4-day first class cricket, because he's not going to represent India in test cricket for quite a while. I think so he must make it clear officially, but he hasn't done that. But I think he will do that in due course, because if someone's body is only capable of handling the load of white ball cricket, then why force the player, or why shove the test format down the throat of his player and jeopardize his career as well as India's chances in the white ball format. So this thought and this scenario was taken into consideration by the BCCI. And we know, when Rohit Sharma was not the captain of the T20 team, Hardik Pandya, whenever fit, used to captain Team India in the T20 format, and he did brilliantly well. When Hardik Pandya got injured, Surya Kumar Yadav took over the reins of captaincy in the T20 format. Hardik Pandya is also looked as a suitable replacement for Rohit Sharma after the conclusion of the ODI career of Rohit Sharma, which I think in all likelihood will come in the 2025 Champions Trophy. So he is being groomed as a long-term successor as well. And if Hardik Pandya's body isn't be able to cope with the demands of the ODI format as well, then KL Rahul will take over from Rohit Sharma. But currently what I'm talking about, the pecking order, is that Hardik Pandya is number 2 after Rohit Sharma in the ODI format as well. So if you are a captain of the ODI format, then it doesn't make sense to eliminate the name of player just because he's not turning up in the Ranji Trophy, because his body won't be able to cope with the rigors, and he doesn't want to. So no point in forcing him or just holding gun to his temple, and you have to play this amount of test first class cricket for Baroda now. And one other distinction that people are comparing Shreyas Iyer and Ishan Kishan with Hardik Pandya. Actually, both of them, I'm talking about Shreyas Iyer and Ishan Kishan respectively, were available, were fit, and they could have easily represented their respective sides, that is Mumbai and Jharkhand, in the Ranji Trophy. But actually they did not do that, disregarding the diktat from the BCCI. That's why BCCI terminated their contract. We have to take into consideration that Hardik Pandya is now genuinely injured. He cannot turn up even in the T20 format now. Actually, currently he's recovered and he's playing in the Reliance T20 Cup in Navi Mumbai, which is a corporate tournament, T20 tournament organized by Reliance every year, and he's trying to find his mojo for the IPL. And the basis on the IPL, I'm sure that he's a world-class performer. He will perform well in the IPL too. He will be selected for the T20 World Cup, which is going to take place in the USA and the West Indies. We have to remember that there is just 5-day gap between the end of the IPL final as well as the start of the T20 World Cup. So workload management also becomes critical. That is also one reason that the selectors are not forcing Hardik Pandya to play any sort of red ball cricket, that is test cricket or the first class cricket that is turning up for Baroda for his home state in the Ranji Trophy. Another thing taken into consideration is that unfortunately even since the Hardik Pandya made his debut in January 2016, he has actually missed more than 60 to 65% of the wide ball games also for Team India, and that is due to his various injuries, which can't be helped. I think I gave the reason some time ago in this video only. We don't have to forget that even in IPL, Hardik Pandya misses some games for Gujarat Titans. Last year he missed a couple of games where Rashid Khan was the captain. He filled in his role as an interim captain. He missed some games in the 2022 edition as well, but it was a cautious approach by him, which resulted in great dividends for the Gujarat Titans. We all remember the magnificent performance that he put forward against Rajasthan Royals in the final. So Hardik Pandya turns up whenever his IPL side also needs, and whenever India also needs. Many people forget that according to their own convenience, historically I can count out many innings where Hardik Pandya has saved our blushes and at least gave us some respectability in defeat as well. The prime example being the Champions Trophy. We shamelessly lost that final by 178 runs, and if not for Hardik Pandya's cameo of 76 runs, we could have lost that match by by more than 250 runs. So that would have been a different kind of embarrassment. So he saved us from defeat. We have to remember the 2022 match in which Virat Kohli famously hit Haris Rao for a couple of sixes. Hardik Pandya was with Virat Kohli right till the end. He also scored a valuable 50. Don't forget that he also scored a 50 against England in the semi-final. His contribution was very good. I think he scored a 50 or a quick fire 40 something. That's what propelled India's score to above 160, because we were so timid that if not for Hardik Pandya's cameo, we would have scored at least 140 or 145. Nevertheless, we lost that match by 10 wickets as well. That was a pretty pathetic defeat as well, but once again Hardik Pandya saved us the blushes. One more inning I am remembering is the 2022 group stage innings in the T20 format against Pakistan in the Asia Cup. That was also, match was even Stevens and Pakistan had the upper hand until Hardik Pandya arrived. He turned up with the ball as well as the bat as well. So these are the contributions that I remember of Hardik Pandya. In Asia Cup group stage also he performed pretty well last year. against Pakistan or couple of years back. So he has turned up for his country when his country needs him the most, and we just have to spare him some flack. He deserves the grade A contract, and yeah, hopefully he performs well and he finds his mojo in the current corporate tournament. Hopefully he has a great IPL for the Mumbai Indians, although I don't agree with their decision to remove Rohit Sharma as captain, but now that the line has been set in stone, no point in arguing over that. And hopefully, most importantly, he turns up for India in June when we need him the most in the T20 format. So how did you like my analysis of this news? Hope I cleared the air, and please tell me that in the comment section below, and don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel, and press the bell icon for further notifications. We'll meet in the next video. Till then, everyone, bye, take care.